Shannon and Nate, here we are again. Hey Shannon, what if you get to the final walkthrough and the TV mounts are gone that were holding the TVs on the wall?
Well, that's hopefully something the listing agent has discussed with the seller previous to that point and removed from the contract, because the contract does include that those fixtures would remain with the property. So you could take the TV, but you would need to leave the TV mount. So if it's missing, you want to address that in your buyer pre-walkthrough closing form. You can send that off as a cure notice, hopefully get that resolved before closing and work something out to get that replaced.
Excellent. I'm going to throw you a curveball.
Okay.
So yesterday I had a seller. I sold their house. Mm-hmm. The new buyer called them and said, "Hey, come remove your your satellite dish." They had a Dish Network dish, and when they called Dish Network, they said that satellite dish was owned by the previous owner.
Oh, that's interesting. So the contract reads that those things would convey, and I'm gonna just before I say that, excluding TVs.
See,
you can throw me a curveball. Media, antenna, satellite dishes that are affixed do remain. So they would either need to work with the satellite company to transfer that or work out a separate agreement for the buyer to have it removed.
Yeah, and in this case, Dish Network does not want the satellite dish. Mm-hmm. It's like a disposable razor. It's easier for them just to leave it there. Mm-hmm. They do want you to return your receivers and your remotes, but as far as the dish goes, they don't want it.
Okay, interesting. Good to know.